Hello everyone. In this tutorial, we are going to learn the basics concepts related to the ARM programming with embedded C. So in this lecture series of ARM programming with embedded C, we are going to cover these four topics. First is introduction to LPC2148, which we are going to cover in this tutorial. Then in the next tutorials, we are going to cover GPIO ports of LPC2148 microcontroller, timer modes of LPC2148 microcontroller, and pulse width modulator configuration. So LPC2148 microcontroller is based on ARM7 architecture, and in this slide we are going to see some features of this microcontroller. So it is 16 or 32 bit microcontroller based on ARM7 family. It is having 512 kilobytes of ROM memory, that is read only memory, where we store program, and we are having 40 kilobytes of RAM memory, that is random access memory. This microcontroller is having two 10 bit ADCs which provide total 14 analog inputs. So we can say we are having two 10 bit ADCs with 14 channels. Okay, so we can connect up to 40 analog sensors or analog inputs to this particular microcontroller. We are having single 10 bit DAC, that is nothing but digital to analog converter, which provides variable analog output. We are having two 32 bit timers. We are having one watchdog timer. Apart from these, there are various serial communication protocols available in this LPC2148 microcontroller. We are having two I2C bus, that is inter integrated circuit bus, then two UART, that is universal asynchronous receiver transmitter, two SPI SSP, and one USB communication protocols. So all these are features of this LPC2148 microcontroller. Now next is general purpose input output. So general purpose input output is nothing but this is nothing but the pins which are available to any microcontroller. Now these pins we can use as an input or as an output. So if we use that particular pin as an input, then we can take signal from the outside world into the microcontroller. If we declare that particular pin as output, then through that particular pin we can send signals to the outside world. Okay, so it can either input pin or output pin. Input pin is used to take signal or data from outside devices. Output pin is used to send signal or data to outside devices. A group of these pins is called as port. Okay, so if we combine several pins of particular microcontroller into one set, then it is called as port. Now this port names are different for different microcontrollers. For example, in LPC2148 we are having port 0 and port 1. Okay, and port 0 is having 32 pins. Okay, so basically LPC2148 we are having two 32 bit general purpose input output ports, which are nothing but port 0 and port 1. Now different microcontrollers are having different naming. For example, if I talk about another microcontrollers, then they may have this naming port A. If we talk about pins, suppose port A is having 32 pins, then these pins are defined like this: PTA1, PTA2, PTA0, likewise. Okay, so similarly in LPC2148 we are having two port, that is port 0 and port 1. So this pin can be defined as P0.1, which indicate port 0.1 pin, port 0.2 pin, and likewise we can define these pins pins in this way. So we'll talk about the total general purpose input output pins which are available to the LPC2148. So port 0 is having total 32 pins. Out of these 32 pins, 28 pins can be configured as either general purpose input or output. Okay, now remaining pins we are not having, or we cannot access remaining pins. So these 28 pins are divided like this. We can access port 0.0 pin, so we can access from 0 to 23rd pin, that is total 24 pins we can directly access. Then 25th pin is we're having one more pin, so 24 is not available. and then we are having 28 to 30, so total 3 pins. Okay, so if we combine 24 plus 1, 25 and then 3, which is nothing but 28 pins. Okay, now one of these 32 pins can be configured as general purpose output pin only, which is nothing but 31 pin. Okay, three of these 32 pins, that is P0.24, 26 and 27, are reserved. Hence they are not available for use. Okay, so please remember this point. 24, 26 and 27, they are reserved. We cannot use these pins. Port 1 is also 32 bit port, but out of this 32 bit or out of these 32 pins, we can use only 16 pin. Okay, so only 16 of these 32 pins, which are P1.16 to 31. Okay, so P1.0 to P1.15 pins are not available from port 1 of this LPC2148. Okay, so if we calculate total number of GPIO pins which are available to the LPC2148, which are nothing but 45. Okay, so port 0 are having 29 pins and port 1 are having 16 pins. Okay, so 29 plus 16 is equal to 45. So we are having total 45 GPIO pins, which we can define as an input or output. Now this is pin diagram of this LPC2148. So we are having total 64 pins in this LPC2148, and these pins are defined like this: P0.21, P0.22, okay, so P1.19. okay, now if we see, then to almost all pins they are having multiple functionality. Now what does it mean? This pin number 1 we can use as a P0.21, so we can use this port 0's 21 pin as a GPIO pin, plus it is having PWM signal, so we can have PWM5, so we can generate PWM signal on this pin also. We are having AD1.6, that is analog to digital converter pin, and we are having capture pin also. Okay, so this pin is having 4 different functionalities, and with the help of some registers we can select one functionality at a time from this pin. Okay, so similarly, see, this second pin is having multiple functionalities. Okay, then this 13 pin is also having multiple functionalities. Okay, so out of these multiple functionalities we can select one operation at a time. Maximum 4 functionalities are available and minimum is 1. Okay, now as I discussed in the previous slide, almost every pin of these two ports has some alternate function available. For example, P0.0 can be configured as TXD, that is transmission pin, for UART0 or PWM pin as well. The functionality of each pin can be selected using pin function select register. So there is a special functional register is available for selection of this particular functionality. Okay, for example, in LPC214X pin diagram above, which is mentioned in the previous slide, pin number 1 is labeled as P0.21, then PWM5, AD16, CAP1.3. It means this pin can have 4 modes or different 4 functions. It can be either this, this or this or this. We can select one function at a time with the help of this pin function select register. Okay, thank you.